Hello students, welcome back to the class. In the last class we have discussed about the factors of regionalism. In the last class we have discussed about the definition and what are the factors which are mainly responsible for regionalism. So now in this class we will continue the same topic, factors which are responsible for regionalism. I am going forward. So okay, first one, we should know what is meant by regionalism. Okay, according to the definition which was given by S.R. Maheshwari, she said that a particular territory, whenever a particular territory is set apart as a region, when the territories are containing with the different variables with a different degree, okay, then that is called as regionalism. So according to S.R. Maheshwari, what she said that a particular territory is considered or a part of set apart as a region, and if the territories contain different variables along with a different degree, okay, which is called as region. So different variables in the form of geography, if the particular territory have different geographical features, if they have different topography, physical features, physical structure of land, religions, languages, customs, okay, and if they have a sentiment of togetherness, then that particular territory will be considered as a region. So that definition was given by S.R. Maheshwari. So what she has given the definition? S.R. Maheshwari has given a definition that when a particular territory is set apart as a region, when this particular territories when contain different variables along with a different degree, different variables in the form of different geographical features, different topography, different religions, different language, different customs, and when there is a sentiment of a feeling of togetherness among the people, then that particular territory will be considered as a region. Now in the last class we have discussed already that there are many factors which are responsible for the causes of and the rise of regionalism. So there are many factors, okay, demanding for the separate region. So there are many factors which are mainly responsible for the rise of regionalism or regional movement. These factors mainly includes political factors, some are political factors, okay, some are mainly because of political parties, and some are mainly because of economic factors, because of regional imbalance. Some regions feel highly well developed, but some other regions when there are not well developed, then a particular feeling will come, regionalism movement will start. Okay, we can find children, almost all the regions will not develop equally. So whenever economic, in the sense regional imbalance, if there is a regional imbalance regarding economy, then that type of movements will start, which is called as regionalism. Okay, that is one part, regional imbalance. Now cultural factors are also responsible. When there is a difference culture, okay, when the culture is quite different, okay, when there is a common culture, then you can't find, the movement will start, the rise of regionalism will not start. But when you are finding different culture, different language, then the concept of regionalism normally will start. So regionalism is perceived, understanding as a multi-dimension phenomena. Okay, regionalism is perceived as a multi-dimension phenomena. Multi-dimension phenomena is nothing but anything with different parts and different aspects, different way of appearance. A thing, anything which have different way of appearance is called as multi-dimension factors. So regionalism is perceived as multi-dimension factors which contains different geographical area, different language, different culture, okay, but a sentiment of feeling of togetherness, that is called as region. Regionalism is considered and perceived as a multi-dimension factors. Multi-dimension factors means I have already said that anything with the different parts of appearance. Now the factors which is extending, overlapping, okay, these factors which are overlapping and responsible for the emergence of regionalism is the following factors we'll discuss now. What is this factor? Is this is the second factor, children, which is mainly responsible for the rise of regionalism. Slow pace of development. Whenever the speed of development is very low, whenever the pace of development, okay, the speed of development is very low in various region, or when that leads for the failure of national leadership, Okay, this is perceived as a failure of national leadership. So suppose if there is no proper development in a particular region, so we will treat that leaders are mainly responsible, and because of the leaders and the political leaders who are not developing the states well. So whenever the particular states are not developing, the mainly responsible is who is ruling the states. Okay, here also slow development. In most, we already seen that up to 30 years the Congress party have ruled. From 1947 to 1967, overall if you see 30 years the Congress party have dominated. Before also, before 1937 election also the Congress party, okay, during the period of British rule, election started in 1937, okay, 1937 to 1967, overall 30 years the Congress party have ruled. So elections were started during British period. Okay, 1937 is the first time where many Congress party came to power. But in 1967, most of the national Congress party, they lost their elections in nearly 8 to 9 states. In 1967, during this period, most of the national leaders were lost. Mainly responsible is this is only, slow pace of development. Because of slow pace of development in the various regions, that led for the failure of national leadership. National leaders were failed to come for the upmark. Okay, so because they are unable to develop the states, and that's why, because of the main reason is slow pace of development is mainly responsible for the failure of national leadership. And because of that reason, many people went for an alternative source, and that is called as regional leadership. Because national leadership was already failed, because people wanted a fast development. Every person wanted development should be very fast. If there is a slow pace of development, then most of the people, what they perceive, that is nothing but a failure of national leadership who are not developing very fastly. So that's why most of the people has went for the alternative sources. And what is the other alternative sources? Regional leadership. Most of the people believe in regional leaders because they believe that regional and the local parties, they can able to understand the problems locally and they can able to solve the problems. Okay, due to the sentiment of language and due to the sentiment of togetherness, culture, religion, these are the main things which most of the people are giving preference to the regional leadership. Second important thing is failure of national party because slow pace of development. Whenever the speed is very low, then the people perceive that is mainly because of national leadership failed. And that's why the people has went for the alternative sources, and that is called as regional leadership. Next one, if you see the resources are quite scarce, okay, resources are quite less. On the other hand, if the resources are less but the economic development of the people are more, okay, people wanted more. So economic demand of the people is quietly more, okay, according to the resources. If you are talking about best example, for example, India. In India, if you see that the main important resources, most of our resources are very less. Such as the best example, I'll say you petrol. Petrol is one resources which are quite less in our country, and that's why the demand is increasing. When the cost of petrol will be high, that will greatly affect upon all the other resources also. So here are the main thing is the resources are very less. But if you see the size of population, our size of population is more, and the demand of economic demand is also more. So this is also one reason. So and most of the people disproportionately, okay, the demand is also very very high, and these conditions also led for the mass deteriorated. Okay, so this is mainly responsible for the mass demand for regional leadership. This is one point. So whenever if you see that when the resources are less or when the resources are more, if the resources will be more, then what will happen? Economic demand of the people can be able to satisfy. If the economic demand of the people will be satisfied, then they never go for regionalism. But here what is happening, because of the less resources, the people are unable to fulfill the demands, and that's why the demands are increasing, and that leads for one more alternative sources which is called as regionalism. On the other hand, if you see that people are realizing, when the people realize that this is very difficult to achieve the development in the national leadership, when the people feel that this is very difficult for the development of national leadership, then the people will try to support the regional leadership for development of social and economic development. So when the demands are not satisfied, then only the most of the people are going for the regionalism and they are supporting the regional leadership. Because when the demand will be satisfied, the people will never go for regional or regionalism or regional leadership. So this is the main thing. So children, what we have discussed, this is the second factor we have discussed. Already I said you, according to the S.R. Maheshwari, she is saying that a particular territory, whenever a particular territory is set apart as a region which contain different variables along with different degree. Whenever the territories contain different variables like geography, when it contain different topography, religion, language, customs, but a sentiment of feeling of togetherness, then that is called as regionalism. If you see that there are many factors which are responsible for the rise of regionalism, okay, this includes political, economic and cultural factors which are mainly responsible for regionalism, and regionalism is perceived as a multi-dimensional phenomenon. Okay, so sometimes the political factors are responsible for regionalism, sometimes economic regional imbalance, and sometimes the cultural factors also responsible, language and some other cultural also responsible for regionalism, and that's why regionalism perceived as multi-dimensional phenomena. Anything with different parts of appearance, which looks different form of appearance. Okay, that is called as multi-dimensional phenomena. If you take an example, the factors which are extending the regionalism is mainly responsible for the emergence of regionalism. So these are the mainly factors. If you see, what are the factors? Political factors, social and cultural factors are mainly responsible to expand, and these are mainly responsible for the emergence of regionalism. Next, we'll go forward. The main second important point, if you see, the reasons that led for the regionalism is slow pace of development. Whenever the development speed is very slow, and whenever the development speed is very slow in various region, then that leads for the failure of national leadership. Okay, whenever the speed will be very low, then that is nothing but when the speed is low, then we will, who is responsible for the development? Government only. So we will blame government only. So that leads for the development failure of national leadership. We already know that national level, most of the country in India, okay, there was only one party, National Party only, and Indian Congress Party. This Congress Party have ruled 30 years all over the state, but because of low pace of development, then the people started refusing the National Party and they started giving importance to the regional party. The main thing is the demand is not meeting for development, and that's why the people went for the emergence of some alternative source which is called as regional party. Imagine that here, if the national party started developing all the regions equally and more development will take place, then people will never go for any alternative resources. The main thing here is what? The failure of national party is mainly, national leadership is mainly responsible. Because of the national leadership, that leads for the slow pace of development, and that's why the people has went for some alternative source which is called as regional leadership. On the other hand, children, if you see that resources, on the other hand, in our country, if you see the minerals, there are some sufficient minerals we have, most of the resources are very less. On the other hand, when you are talking about some liquid minerals like petrol, gas, okay, these resources are very less in our country. So this is the main resources. So whenever the resources are very less, then what will happen? Resources are less in the country, but the economic demand of the people are more. Okay, economic demand for the people are more. This is also leads for the, this conditions leads to diverge towards regionalism. Whenever the demand is met, whenever the economic demand, when the resources will be more, when the economic demand will met, then the people will never go for any alternative resources. But here what is happening in the country, our resources are in a sufficient quantity, which are very less. Okay, there are some resources which are quite very, very less, which we are not self-sufficient also. We have to import that resources from other countries, like petrol. From other countries we are importing petrol. Okay, 75%, more than 70% of imports are nothing but petrol only. So when we are importing all the resources, what is happening? Here the demand of the people are not meeting, economic demand of the people are not satisfied, and that's why the people are going for some alternative resources. So this is also one thing. People realizing that it's difficult to develop the nation, okay, development is not possible. Whenever the people feel in the mind that national development is not possible due to the national leader, then the people will go for some alternative source, and that is called as regionalism. Okay, there are many states which are developing. As soon as when the regional leadership was formed, so rapid development has taken places in many states also. So if the people start realizing, if the people feel that, if the people started realizing that development, to attain the development, it is not possible by the national leader, when they lose their hopes upon the national leadership, then only the people are going for one more importance, and that is called as regional leadership. So they will give importance to the regional leadership for socio-economic development. So this is one point. So children, what we have discussed about the regionalism. In this point, what second factors we have studied, that the main thing is the slow pace of development. Whenever the pace of development is very slow, the people are giving more importance to the regional leadership, and that leads for the failure of national leadership, because in the initial level, in the initial pace of political parties, national leaders plays important role. But when the national leaders are ruling our country, there was a slow pace of development, and that is the reason people has went for some alternative resources. And one more second thing is, resources are very less in our countries, resources are quite scarce, but the demand of the people are more, and that is also one of the reason. When the people lost their hopes upon the national leadership, when the people feel that there will be no development can be achieved due to the national leadership, then only the people will give the supports to the regional leadership for the socio-economic development. So this is also one factors. The main factors is development. So children, will meet you in the next class, and we will discuss about what are the other third important factors which are mainly responsible for regionalism. Okay, we'll meet you in the next class, students. Thank you very much, everybody.